Welcome to Minity Maths. In this video, we are going to look at how to simplify surds. For an explanation of what a surd is, watch our video named What is a Surd? What does simplifying a surd mean? Simplifying a surd means to rewrite a surd where the number under the root sign doesn't have a perfect square as its factor. This is called its simplest form. When working with surds, it is often best to convert them to their simplest forms to make the expression or equation easier to read, understand, and work with. There are a few rules to learn which will help you to simplify surds, and in this video, we will focus on simplifying by multiplication. Here is the first rule. You can use this rule to turn the number under the root sign into smaller numbers. Let's look at this example. To simplify the square root of 20, we need to find two factors which multiply together to make 20. We can break this apart into two smaller numbers. However, to simplify using this rule, one of the factors should be a perfect square greater than 1. If we list the factors of 20, we will see that 4 times 5 contains a perfect square, 4. So by the rule above, we can rewrite the square root of 20 using these factors. We can now simplify this further by finding the square root of 4, which is 2. Whenever we have a whole number multiplied by a surd, we can omit the multiplication sign and write it like this. Let's look at another surd and try to simplify using the same rule. So again, we make a list of all the factors of 15. None of these factors are perfect squares above 1. Therefore, this surd is already in its simplest form. Another rule we can use to simplify surds is the reverse of the last one and involves multiplying two surds together. Let's look at an example. So by following the above rule, we can multiply the 2 and the 3 together. The answer cannot be simplified any further, as 6 does not have any perfect squares as its factors. Here is a more complicated example. Remember that the multiplication signs between the whole numbers and the surds have been left out. We can rearrange this expression so that we can multiply the whole numbers together first. Next, we multiply the surds using the above rule. But can we simplify this further? Thinking back to the previous rule, let's list the factors of 18 to check if this is in its simplest form. 9 is a perfect square, so we can use these two factors to rewrite the surd. Now we can calculate the square root of 9, as this is not a surd. Lastly, we multiply the whole numbers together again, and as the number under the root sign has no square factors greater than 1, this is now in its simplest form. Finally, here is another rule, where multiplying a surd with the same number under the root sign will always result in a whole number, not a surd. For example, multiplying the square root of 5 by itself results in a 5. If we look at the previous rule, we can see why this is, as the square root of 25 is 5. In this example, we are also squaring the square root of 3, i.e. multiplying it by itself. Have a go at this question to find the area of this shape. Pause the video while you work it out. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to Minity Maths for more videos.